Hi guys. So today I'll be talking about the installation process of the Dukexplorer body kit from Autologue design. You would already find a video on YouTube which covers the basic installation process as to how you need to put the mounts in place and how you need to put the panels in place in a way that they sit in properly. But I'll covering the areas which have not been discussed, which are mostly wiring and the sequence how I install. As you can already see, I have installed the panels the way they are supposed to be. These are the side panels. I have the tools in place, and there are a couple of bolts that you would actually need which are longer. So if you remember, there are two bolts that go right in front of the tank assembly. You need those longer. So these are the ones which I'm talking about. It's very easy to buy the ones that you need. So you can simply buy these screws. These are longer than the tank panel ones, and these would fit in perfectly fine over here after you put in the cowls in place. First things first, you need to install the stay over here. It's already explained in the video how you need to install it. And right after, what I have done is I have put the plate right on top so that at all times the stay stays aligned and it is straight with the rest of the bike. Right after you're done with the stay, my opinion is work on the wiring. So this is the main wiring harness which comes in from the bike. Put it through the centerpiece and the entire thing, and then zip tie it with a fat one so that it doesn't fall off. Okay, so this thing, the centerpiece is in place. If the centerpiece is in place, the rest of the wiring will be fine. Now then separate the wiring section that goes to the right handle and the wiring section that goes to the left handle. Once you've separated them, I have put the ones for the different sides on each side of the wiring, and I have fixed it. Now I have left this as it is because I need to first check if there's any stress on the wiring. How would I do that? I would turn the handles to the extreme. So you can see there's still a lot of free play over here. Let me turn it the other way around. And there's a lot of free play over here as well. Next up is the headlight section. So there would be the headlight mask which is already available with the bike as it is shown in the video. You'll have to drill it at two points and then install the mask with the rest of the headlight panels and indicators. I'm not covering that because that's already covered, and I'll move on to the next step. Arrange the wiring neatly and tie them up wherever it is needed, keeping in mind that when you pull it upwards, it is not getting stuck at any point or it is not restricting any of the cables on the bike. Once everything is zip tied and all the wiring is in place, connect the headlight to this stay. It should look something like this. Install the side panel. It should sit something like this. And right after, you have to install these bolts. So install these bolts first and then only proceed with the rest of it. Once this is done, install these bolts and then move to these two. Right after you have installed the entire kit the way it is shown, you would see there's one section of the kit which is still left, which is this area. So here you would already have a hole on the kit, or there would be a small provision where you need to get the drill done. Let me just focus in. So this is how it should look. It's on the below section of the kit. Now all you need to do is align it with the radiator cover, this section, and drill a hole onto it. Now if you go by the video, they suggest that you put in a screw, or what I recommend is to put a push clip. A push clip would be something which looks like this. You would get it right off your headlight sides, so you would have four on your motorcycle already. how you need to install. All you need to is push it outwards. Align the kit over here. Put this through the hole and then pop this pin inside. That's how it will stick. Let me do it and then I'll show you how it looks. Once you're done, it would look something like that. Once everything is done, fire the bike up, check all the electricals to ensure that you have connected all the sockets and everything. Rev a little to see if there's any vibration before you finally complete. With that, bye.